We've also reimagined our in-person programs. And I have to say that Rita has been really wonderful in being a crucial part of that experimentation. And in particular, a lot of our programming is typically done with companies. And companies are, at first, we told the companies that we were going to go virtual. And they said, okay, we'll wait until we can come back in person. But over time, they have become more open to virtual. And what's true about virtual is that it is not all Zoom classes are created equal. And in some ways, what we've done here at Columbia Executive Education, together with the help of our stellar faculty, which include Rita, is we have really gone out and reimagined the classroom in a virtual environment. And Rita, I don't know if you want to tell us a little bit about some of the different tools that you utilize and techniques and the advantages of the virtual platform over the in-person platform.
Sure. So the best example, I think, is our Women in Leadership program, which when it runs in its in-person modality is a three-day, you know, intensive, drinking from a fire hose. Everybody comes together and it's great. And you've got like 45 women in a room and it's just, the energy is wonderful. And sad we can't have that. But I was thinking about the population that we're serving and what they're going through, especially right now. And so the program is targeted at women, you know, typically 15 years or so into their careers, at that critical moment when, you know, everything is on their shoulders. Typically they've got family to think about, they've got career challenges, they're trying to figure out what they really want in terms of the next step for themselves. But now we later on top of that, we have, you know, many of them have kids at home, many of them have spouses who are also working, and they're all doing it, you know, in a confined space. And so I thought to myself, well, what are the pressures on them? And the first pressure on them is just intense time pressure. There's just not enough time in the day to fit everything in. Second is everything they do that isn't already committed to either their jobs or their families requires somebody else to step in for them. And so what we did was we took the three-day program and reimagined it as a 2 short days, but stretched over 4 weeks. So it runs from 11 o'clock Eastern to about 3:30 Eastern, with a little break in the middle, you know, for lunch or whatever you need. And we found that's very friendly for the West Coast. People don't have to get up at 4 a.m. It's very friendly for Europe. People can work a full day and then do the class at night and not get to bed like in the middle of the night. And what I've learned is that so much of the real learning and application, because you've stretched the program out more, the participants can actually do a lot more with that program during the breaks and during in between. And I worried about the networking part, that it wouldn't be as rich, but we put them in breakout groups. We have them working together on projects. So there's one segment of the course, for example, where they spend a full hour with 3 other class participants sharing their ideas about their vision, sharing their ideas about what they want, and getting feedback, you know, from people who aren't politically motivated or in their companies or competitors or anything. And so in many ways, the experience was richer than the in-person one, which took me by surprise.
Absolutely. That's wonderful. And I also should mention that this program was put together in partnership with Southern Glazer's Wine and Spirits Company, as well as the Wine and Spirits Wholesalers of America. And in some ways, what the virtual platform is allowing us to do is to more easily and flexibly engage in these sorts of partnerships across space, across continents, and to bring in a much broader set of individuals who maybe wouldn't often be able or have the time to come to New York to take part in what we're doing.